so much the men being Ajeeb Dastans. I mean, though, as of now, we are living Ajeeb Dastans. You know, it just seems like a disaster film script is unfolding around us. But anyways, you all gave us reason to, you know, watch some great content. Were you all surprised at the reception? Because usually, you know, some critics are so tight-fisted with their compliments. Were extremely generous this time. So what is it like for directors to have itna praise aata hai?
We should start with the director who got the most praise. Yeah. You want to answer?
Well, I mean, the way I am, I think because fundamentally, I kind of diss my own work a lot, okay? I'm always unsure. I'm always that, have I done it right? So I'm always questioning. I'm always looking at the AR. I should have taken that shot. I should have used that take instead. Why did I do this? So I'm constantly that. So for me, whatever criticism comes in, I really take it to the chin. And I really think that there's been a fair bit of criticism also, which has not come out in the mainstream spaces. But I'm really liking the healthy mix of it. And I wanted to take up the challenge of having that complexity of, you know, like people getting divided on a certain thing. The polarity of opinion. I mean, yeah. It's good to have. And that's the complexity that I was aspiring to. That it should not have an easy way out. Maybe it works for some, it doesn't work for some. Some people feel that this person is evil. Some people feel that this person is evil. So it's good. It's good to have that all mix.
What about the three of you?
So if I'm completely honest, before the film release, like about 10 days, the build-up before the film release, I was always thinking that, oh, I've really messed up this film. I don't know what I have done. A film without words. What have I done? And started end of my career. But honestly, when people started reacting well to it initially, I was pleasantly surprised. And of course, and there have been some bad reviews as well, and I've read them. And some correct reviews which pointed out certain things that I said, yeah, I agree with what they're saying, especially on a critical level. So I personally think I got more than I deserve, and I'm over. I thought I'll get like some people say something nice, a lot of people say not nice, but yeah, I'm quite happy overall.
And Raj and Shashank, both your films very different from the kind of films that you make for the big screens. You know, totally shifted gears. So were you also pleasantly surprised with that praise coming in? Because I mean, Shashank, can't imagine Lipakshi, a movie, 2.5-hour film with Lipakshi as the driving force being made. Tab to bahut hi sawal, vivad hota.
Well, man, I've not thought of that. कि यू नो लिपाक्षी और या बज्जू का अगर की कहानी अगर 2 घंटे की कहानी होती तो मैं क्या करता. आई शुड हैव प्रॉब्ली थॉट अबाउट इट बट टू बी रियली ऑनेस्ट इन फैक्ट इट्स सरप्राइजिंग वी वर जस्ट चैटिंग अबाउट इट इन द ब्रेक दैट आई डोंट रीड रिव्यूज नॉट अ सिंगल वन ऑफ देम. आई जस्ट हैव इंटरेक्टेड विद अ लॉट ऑफ पीपल हु हैव मैसेज्ड मी स्पोकन टू मी कॉल्ड मी लॉट ऑफ देम हैव गुड थिंग्स टू दे सम ऑफ माई फ्रेंड्स फिल्म मेकर्स दे हैव गिवन मी क्रिटिकल फीडबैक एंड आई एम जस्ट हैप्पी दैट आई एम गेटिंग टू टेल स्टोरीज. And people in these times are taking out time and watching it. I think we are living a charmed life, just being able to put out content in times like this. And I have immense gratitude for everyone who has watched it. And I think I just want to keep having these opportunities in my life that I get to make content, people see it, whether they appreciate it, whether they don't, that is all depends on them. But I'm just very, very grateful that I got this opportunity.
And as Raj said, that Khilona was his version of bad news, and which actually, out of the 4 stories, shook up most because everyone was like, what was that?
Yeah. No, so I think when I chose this subject to make, I knew we were treading a very fine line and it could go either way, and it has. But to answer your question about whether we were expecting this sort of a response to the anthology, I don't think anyone expects this kind of a response or even, you know, thinks that they'll get close to it. But yes, when I did see all the other 3 films, which was actually very close to the release, I knew that we had a solid anthology in our hands. And I knew that, you know, my film I know could have gone either way, and it has. But even the other films, I realized that we had good content, you know, in all the short films that we have. Whether you like it, not like it, that really just depends on you. I mean, it's an opinion at the end of the day. And depending on where you come from and your background, you could, you know, interpret in your own way and choose, pick and choose which one you like. But overall, as a film, as an anthology, I was pretty sure that we have a solid anthology in our hands and, you know, people will like it. Yeah.
And also now, to the all four of you have actually handled, you know, topics of gender, female sexuality, infidelity, privilege, and representation of, you know, a certain, caste. But there is no judgment. Usually filmmakers are also humans, and humans tend to judge. Their own personal biases do come into the representation. But it's beautiful how you all have kind of detached yourself and left it out in the open for people to make those judgments. Was it actually tough when you all set out to make these stories?
I think it's actually important to do that, right? I don't think you can tell a story objectively if you, start judging your characters or have a particular, you're already, you know, skewed towards one side. I think you have to just look at it from the outside objectively. And that's the only way I feel you can do a justice story. And all of these films here that we're talking about deal with, you know, complicated relationships and dynamics and, you know, so I think it's important to have the objective perspective for you as a filmmaker to be able to say that story effectively and, you know, without taking sides. So I think it's actually a prerequisite before you make the film to kind of not be judgmental.
Neeraj, what about you? Because you have said so much in 40 minutes, so much. But, you know, sometimes the biases do come in. I mean, it's really empowering to see these narratives coming out. But how difficult is it for filmmakers to actually, you know, the biases, your own biases do also come in to distance yourself and saying, let me not take any sides here.
I actually agree that there's a tendency that happens because you're so dear to it. In fact, I just want to quote, I want to talk about something that happened to me soon after Masaan. I pursued something for 3 years, okay? And this was a story that was very, very dear to me. It's something that heavily moves me. Like it was a farmer suicide story. I went with it for 3 years, pursued it. And then I realized that I am too attached, I'm too overwhelmed by the issue, whereas I'm not cracking a story. I'm not finding a character. I'm force fitting it into a story, into a narrative. And I realized that that's not right. It's again, even if it is good, it's propaganda at the end. So I actually parted my way with that story. So even in this one, I wanted to take up the challenge of having to show duality in people. And if we don't acknowledge duality in people, then we are just like trying to put up tropes. You know, there's going to be either only black or white, which is what conventionally cinema has been in for many years. So, and now it's, I think, the time to liberate ourselves and to not put the pressure on protagonist or antagonist or whatever, and just have very, I think what it does is it humanizes our characters when we show their vulnerability, when we show them flawed. I think that is where we as filmmakers will, as narrative people, have to aspire for. Otherwise, if we are explicitly putting out polemics, or if you're saying that this is how it should be, we are still propaganda at the same time.
True.
That's what I feel.
And to Kayo and Shashank, Kayo, like in your story, I mean, you see her, I mean, it's looked at infidelity in a very, very sensitive way also. And I like the fact the way it ends, like she's walked in, she's broken, but had we seen this in a Hindi film, वो पति को जाके कहती कि मैंने आपके साथ ये किया है, उससे अपना सूटकेस लेके भाग जाती. But I just like that she's carrying on with her life. And there is one person across that door whose life, whose heart is shattered. But it's just the way it is.
I'll tell you what I feel honestly is that, as Neeraj just said, the minute you have a white character or a dark character, you don't connect with that character, because as human beings, we are not white or black. We are completely gray, and we make difficult choices. Sometimes we make the wrong choices, and we make a selfish choice or we make the right choice. Now, a lot of people have told me, especially in the climax of Ankahi, is that I don't agree with what she did. But there's some people who say I completely agree with what she did, because that is what she as a character believed. So the idea, I think the idea, of course, I don't think it would ever have had that. Pati ko jaake kehna, I don't think I would ever go down that road. But I do.
Aray, many Hindi films have ended with the woman like walking out saying, "Maine bahut bada ek, fir apna."
Yeah, and and I don't think she made the right decision, and I don't think she made the wrong decision. I think at that moment in time, what she thought was the right thing to do is what she did, and she had to let go, no matter what. So, do I agree with it? Maybe not. Maybe yes, I do. But that's not up to me. That's what I put out the question somewhere, and the writers, we all put out the question that this is what would you do if you were here, and you will connect with it and say, I agree or not. And I think that's the case, not just with Ankai, but with the other films as well, is that, you know, they always leave you at a point of thought. They leave you at a question mark, which is so much nicer, because I always feel that you've made a good film. Is that after the film, on the way home, the family in the car is arguing about what they thought was right.
Totally. And this is what I want to tell Shashank, is because when these open ends happen, viewers like me sit and the entire night are devising an alternate end. What would have happened?
Right.
You know? So with Lipakshi,
I think that was also... Sorry.
Yeah.
What happened with Lipakshi? Yeah, I will. I'm going to explore that. What happened with her? But you know, that was one of the ideas when you kind of get an opportunity to write stuff like that. You know, and when I'm writing something like Majnu, there's a little bit of me in all my characters. There's a little bit of, you know, in a Bablu, in a Lipakshi, in a Rajkumar Mishra, and then there are some things which are not me. Something which is just born of what the character is. And I think ultimately you want to make stuff like this, like. For me, in the last few years, the two most defining things that I've watched on TV, which have been something which I want to learn from, is Jojo Rabbit and Delhi Crime. You know, when I saw narratives like that, when I saw Delhi Crime, I was just blown about by, like, how can this person make a film and he has not judged anything in the film? It's based on such a tragedy, and there was so much news about it, and yet he's given a perspective, Richie Mehta, to a story which could have had, you know, such a clear, as you could, a crowd-pleasing end, if you can call it. But yet he has made something which is so non-judgmental. And I think as I grow in life, as I grow as a filmmaker, I want to aspire to make content like that. I want to aspire to make stories which are more layered, and whereby I'm also constantly redefining the perspective from which I'm coming in. So I think this was a starting step. This is the first time I've done something on OTT. And because we're getting the kind of appreciation and love that we are, I think it just gives us more wings to fly when we get the next opportunity.
And absolutely, I want to ask this again to all four of you. I mean, the last year we have seen a kind of a churn in the film industry and industries across the world. There's more inclusivity, more sensitive narratives, topics are being discussed, and it's not kept, you know, we are not brushing things under the carpet. What do you think going forward? Have we learned something, and where is this going to take us?
You mean the pandemic, or you mean...
The situation. There's been a lot of churning in the industry. There's of inclusivity, you know, big equality, and also in terms of narrative. Do you think going forward, where is it going to take us? Because the film industry is the first place that gets the brickbats also.
I mean, I feel certainly there is a change that I can sense it. I mean, I would say not because of particular events that have happened, but I think people have always been sensitive towards that side and appreciative of true talent, regardless of where it comes from. Yes, there is a definite thing that you talk about, the access to certain kind of privileged positions that you draw upon from. But how do you, what do you make of it is what I think defines you, and how you, how your talent eventually stands the test of time. That I feel, and also secondly, in terms of representation, we are really, really coming up, but of course we have a very, very long way to go.
Yeah,
we have absolutely long, long way to go. I mean, basics itself, let's start with, like, you know, female representation, something that I constantly ask about. For instance, in the Light and Grip team or in the DOP team, there are hardly any women. You know, I mean, I actually checked with DPs that can you at least get your first AC or second AC? Things like that we have to bring in and say that, you know, it's not just interns that we're going to hire. We're also going to hire women in power positions. It does not add up if you just like do it a token movement. So even in HODs, and I'm not saying that we have to compromise on talent. It's just that we have to find from the set of people who have been denied, say Muslims, say LGBTQ, say Dalits, So I think we have to do that. Unless we at least have the second generation of filmmakers, at least if we don't start it, it's going to perpetuate. And I think we all are trying in some way or the other.
Shashank, Raj, do you Absolutely. Want to have anything to say?
Honestly, I think Neeraj put it extremely well. And he not just mentioned about the kind of cinema that we are the messages we are trying to portray, but also what's behind the curtain and what happens on our sets and what happens in all of that. And I do believe that we've made progress. We've made slow progress, but it's going in the right direction. I like to believe, maybe I'm idealistic, but I like to believe that in the film industry, we are inclusive. I like to believe that we have welcomed a lot with open arms, and we are the ones that put out a message. Now, how, in what capacity, in what strength, that can be argued. But when it comes to grip team, light, all these things, as Neeraj bang on said, I think that it's slowly evolving and it needs to evolve a lot more.
Yeah.
But at least it's going in the right direction.
And it's going to take time, I feel. I don't think it's going to happen anytime soon. I think we still have, like you just said, a long way to go to True. Reach the ideal level of representation. But, you know, like I said, as long as we keep making some efforts and progressing in the right direction, hopefully soon.
You know, and it'll happen in forums like that because, you know, four of us would not probably come together if this anthology wouldn't have come together, at least as filmmakers, to chat about. And, you know, now that we have an opportunity, we will speak about, you know, what is your ideology? And once we start engaging in dialogues like this, we will slowly learn from each other and be able to empower. And I think Neeraj just said a very important thing, that we need to take this responsibility forward. We cannot shrug off responsibility and say that we need to take a certain work ethic and ideology forward for future generations as well. Absolutely. And I think that's a responsibility we all need to take seriously.
And both the blockbuster directors, Raj and Shashank, were you like, happy there is no box office here. Gaana nahi dalna hai. Ye kuch nahi karna hai.
Maine gaana bhi dala and I was very disappointed that they had no numbers. Because in fact, I'm so cheap that I was finding numbers even in ratings. And I was irritating all the other directors. We have rated so much and we have done that. And they must be thinking exactly this. That this man is corrupt. He needs numbers everywhere. But on a serious note, it was a bit of a, you know, it was liberating in multiple ways, even from the perspective of story. And even from the perspective of, you could actually sit back and enjoy the film rather than just worry about numbers. But I think both the experiences are a bit different. I mean, having said that, I would love to do more work for OTT, but I miss cinemas. So, you know, it's like, I would like to have them both.
True. And it's going to be a while till we go to the cinemas. We are also living through a very, very trying time. And Absolutely. The industry also, I would say, it's the industry that has given the content that we are surviving on. Imagine if there was no OTT and no YouTube, sab pagal hi ho jate. But as citizens also, as people with influence, what is the message you want to give out as we are living in very, very trying times where our healthcare system is falling apart and trying to get it together? What is that one message you as creators want to give out and as citizens?
I mean, I have a very...
Go ahead.
No, I was just saying...
Raj will set the trend for us, so...
No, Raj, you go, please.
No, Raj, please, happy. Okay, go ahead. Raj, you go.
Okay. So what I want to say is that this is to all the stars and all the big directors and all producers in Bollywood. This is a humble request to all of you. Please use your social media accounts, which have millions of followers, to amplify SOS requests right now. I mean, during this interview, I was actually looking into SOS calls as well. It will benefit a lot of people because they are trying to find a bed, trying to find an oxygen cylinder. They're trying to find remdesivir or anything, any of the medications. It will just help. You know, I understand that you may not be able to clue into it, but have your teams liaise with the people on ground who are doing it. There are a lot of Twitter handles, a lot of Instagram handles who are doing it. Your team can liaise with them and please loan out your accounts for a certain time so that these things can amplify. This is my only message.
Absolutely.
No, and you put that in a bigger picture. I was going to say that we have to, I think compassion is just going to carry us through this entire thing. You just have to, I mean, everyone's kind of trying to, I think, I know everyone around me is trying to help in whatever way they can. One of the most important ways right now immediately is what Neeraj just suggested. And otherwise also, I feel like whatever little you can do, we of course have to be patient. And I think we're in this for the long haul. I don't think we're getting out of this anytime soon. So I think compassion is the key right now, just to be empathetic towards people that you know or people that are around, hopefully, and especially the people who are less privileged. And just be compassionate. Do whatever little you can to help and stay home and be patient, I guess.
Yeah, I mean, of course, completely agreeing with what Neeraj is saying and what Raj is saying. I'll say, just to not be repetitive, is that the times are right now so trying, and people who are absolutely fine sitting at home, they are developing issues of, even realized the last time, of depression of some sort and all of that. Oh. And the only thing I'll put out to the general people is that, please, just for the hell of it, do not share misleading information. I think that it's so easy, and it's such clickbait as it is to put out misleading information, which is what spreads more panic. We are saying that the medical system is falling. No, it's sad that we say that. We just see doctors, nurses, staff, they are working nonstop. They need support. And if you as a person do not want to do anything, you don't have the means, or you don't want to do something, at least don't spread misinformation, because that is causing absolute panic, and your misinformation might kill even one life, and that's absolutely not acceptable.
Absolutely. Yeah.
And I would also definitely say this is purely from my personal experience. My entire family has had it, and they have fought over it, and they have recovered. Especially my parents and my in-laws, who are way beyond their 60s and 70s. I personally felt for them that the first dose of the vaccine definitely helped them battle it. So I would definitely say, once it's available in bigger quantities, take the vaccination drive seriously, because that is ultimately the way we are going to fight it in the future. So I would say, be aware, please read a lot on it. As Kayo said rightly, don't spread misinformation, but keep trying to educate yourself more and more, because every day, unfortunately, the medical professionals are learning more about this pandemic through research every day. You know, it's been such a immense challenge for science as well. So I would say that please keep updating your knowledge as well, and definitely take the vaccination drive seriously, and hopefully we will all fight it and come out stronger in whatever time it takes.
Absolutely. Your lips to God's ears. Thank you so much, gentlemen. And Shashank, Jashizata, mujhe ek baat bata do. Now you said each one of the characters was like you. Now you've come, the film is done. Who is you actually in Majnu?
Entirely koi bhi nahi, yaar. I wish koi na koi to mere jaisa hota, but nahi, koi bhi. I'm a very boring guy. If I start writing films about me, nothing is happening.
Hello. Anyways, thank you so much. Looking forward to you. All your next ventures. And hope the cinemas open and we can lead normal lives. But thank you so much for giving us Ajit Das and gentlemen, and lovely stories. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Bye.